Are there ways for people without having a gut microbiome test to understand that there's something wrong with their gut?
I think the first thing is your symptom. I think when you, for example, I treat a lot of Parkinson's patients right now. I will tell you that the one for Parkinson's, when I take a history of patients with Parkinson's, they inevitably always tell me, Dr. Hazen, I've been constipated for 20 years. It starts in the gut. Listen to your gut. If you've got some indigestion, some abdominal pain, some nausea, some gas, some bloating, some diarrhea, constipation, that's the beginning. And in fact, when you talk to people that have neurological symptoms, the majority of them will tell you, I started having GI symptoms. When you talk to moms with kids with autism, they'll tell you, my kid's poop is one pebble. My kid is having loose stools. My kid is gassy, bloated. So It's important to take the history. So the first thing before a stool test is to take a history. The second thing is looking at your stools in the toilet. Are they floating? Are they green? Are they red? Do you have blood in there? Is there a ring around the toilet? All these things are important when you're thinking. You don't even need a stool test to kind of tell you.